The year was 1993. Whitney Houston's I Will Always Love You was the number one song. Jurassic Park lorded it over to box office.
Can I touch it?
Sure.
The late Fidel Ramos was the president of the Philippines, and very few people knew about the internet. It was also the year Ducati introduced the Monster, arguably the Italian manufacturer's most important model. Last year, Ducati introduced their newest Monster to mixed reviews. People said it didn't look like a Monster. They were looking for the trellis frame. Some even said that it looked and felt a little more Japanese than Italian, which, in my opinion, isn't necessarily a bad thing. But since then, people started warming up to the new Monster, especially when newer colorways started to come out. And today, we get to test drive the most special new edition Ducati Monster, the SP. But since there are two bikes and just one of me, I'm gonna need a little bit of help. So, the lovely Steph Sinco is here to join us in this special episode of Beyond the Ride.
Actually, this is the first time that I'll be trying the Monster in general.
Yes.
So not just the SP. I think I could say I know now why Ducati remains one of the most sought after brands of motorcycles.
30 years. It's been around for 30 years and it's still going strong.
Diba?
Okay.
Speaking of strong, I really felt the bike is super strong. So I've been using different brands of bike and it's just 600cc. But this one... hindi pa siya pumalo ng 1,000 pero man, I can really feel,
you can feel it, the difference.
The difference, the throttle, everything. Yeah. Alam mo talaga na powerful bike siya. Yeah.
I want to ask you, because you're used to the CB650 and the Kawasaki, those are more in the middleweight category, closer to the 600 range.
Yeah.
This one, you're closer to the 1,000 range na. How does it feel difference, not just in the terms of the power, but you know, how it feels compared to a Ducati, compared to a Honda, compared to a Kawasaki?
Iba siya. Hindi pa ako pumapalo ng 5th, 6th gear. Ramdam ko na very, very powerful siya. At the same time, it really can go as fast as you want it to be.
Yeah.
And then at the same time, I think isang brakes. Malaking factor yung the brakes and the suspension. Yeah. Kasi pag medyo maganda na yung speed mo, it's very, very smooth.
Yeah.
As in, kasi pag mababa pa, naghahanap pa siya ng speed eh. Pero once it gets there, talagang very smooth yung ride.
So, most Ducatis don't like going slow.
I know!
Kailangan medyo mabilis.
Oo nga, I heard.
So, it's a little bit, it's the same as the other Ducatis. Mm-hmm.
The SP is powered by the same engine as the base model. A 937cc Testa Stretta L Twin that puts out 111 horsepower at 9,250 RPM and 93.6 newton-meters of torque at 6,500 RPM. What differentiates the SP is some of the other performance parts, just like the fully adjustable all-in suspension front and rear, as well as the top-of-the-line brakes, which are Brembo Stylemas. The SP also comes with a Termagnoni homologated silencer, which just sounds so much better than the stock version.
But I haven't tried the SP yet, and I'm about to try it out as we head back over to Motobox.
Okay.
So we're gonna switch bikes.
Yes.
So as we're riding, and when we get to Motobox, we can discuss further the difference between these two bikes.
All right.
All right. Let's go.
Let's go.
Okay, so for those of you who don't know, the SP stands for Sport Production because, well, this Monster has better performance parts than the base model Monster. In fact, I believe the owner of this unit changed the sprocket as well. It looks and feels very different. I find myself kind of having to tame it a little bit to keep the front wheel down. So knowing who the owner of this bike is, I wouldn't be shocked if he changed the sprocket. The seat height is slightly taller than the standard Monster, which is at about 820 millimeters. The SP is at 840 millimeters. You know, that will make you perched up a little bit more due to the suspension, but I don't really feel a huge difference, to be honest with you. I mean, the seat height is, you know, 20 millimeters is a little bit significant, but I just don't really feel like it's such a big deal as far as maneuvering the bike is concerned, and even putting your foot down in traffic. The steering damper. Well, the steering damper is a very nice touch. And you can, of course, you know, tighten it when you want it to be stiffer, when you're going at speed. And it gives you a little bit more peace of mind and confidence, especially when you're pushing the bike a little bit more. But if it's just a chill ride, and if you're just, you know, going around town, you don't really need it. But of course, if you want that extra bit of safety, you would want a steering damper. And, you know, the truth is, if you're not going to really be pushing the bike, you won't really feel the difference. But when you do push the bike, then, you know, the steering damper comes in very, very handy. Now, the wet weight of the base model is about 188 kilograms. The SP is 186 kilograms. Not that big a difference. In fact, to tell you honestly, I don't feel the difference whatsoever. I mean, people were making a big deal that it's lighter, but the truth is, I don't know if I feel a difference when it comes to the weight of the SP and the base model. What I find a little strange are the riding modes. The base model has road and sport. The SP has road, sport, and wet. Especially since that's more the street or daily ride type of model. You know, whatever the reason, Ducati added an extra safety net with the SP. So in a nutshell, the SP is lighter. It's got better suspension. It's got better brakes, better exhaust, a few more safety features than the standard version. And all in all, honestly, if you add all of that together, it kind of does feel like a different bike. I already like the base model Monster. In fact, if you want to see the review on that, you can actually check the link in the description. And by the way, this also has a fuel gauge, because it does have the same TFT screen as the base model. But it feels different. I mean, I know the suspension makes a big deal. I know the brakes is a big factor. I know for sure now that the sprocket is also a big factor with how this bike is different. And I think that this also has been, you know, decat already. It does sound, I mean, the exhaust note of this bike is just infinitely better than that of the base model. But I do think that this has been already decat.
Alright, so Steph, we just rode back from Sintay to Motobox.
Mm-hmm.
So we got a lot of expressway, we got a little bit of twisties,
yes,
and a little bit of traffic as well.
For me, ha, in my experience, same lang sila, pero yung medyo na feel ko yung difference was with the brakes.
Okay, and different, then, yeah, because they're both Brembos, pero ito yung pinaka-top of the line Brembo.
Oo, iba-iba yung kapit. When I sat down, talagang ramdam ko na ayun yung brake.
Yeah.
But this one, I had to reach for it. Mas malalim siya ng konti.
Yeah.
Pero okay pa rin naman. I mean, the kapit is still there, but it's just a little different talaga.
Yeah.
And then, aside from that, syempre yung pipe niya. So, pag na-start mo yung Monster SP, ramdam mo na agad.
Yeah.
It's explosive. I mean, the sound of it talagang mapapawaw ka talaga eh.
Actually, those were my first words. When I started the bike, when I sat down, and then I gave it a little bit of a rev, iba talaga siya. It really sounds special.
Yun, oh.
I mean,
ang layo eh.
You can feel, it's medyo throaty, mm-hmm. it's deeper, it's a lot louder.
Yes.
So, of course, the pipe is different.
Mm-hmm.
The suspension is all-ins. These are top-of-the-line parts. And for you, because you started with the SP and then you moved down to the regular Monster, was there a big difference in
there
terms?
There is. Diba? Alam mo, medyo nasad ako kasi I thought, parang ano siya, nag-downgrade ako.
Yeah.
So, ganun yung feeling na coming from the SP, tapos I tried the regular one, parang, oh.
And on the flip side, ako naman, I started with the regular one, and then I went to the SP. It doesn't feel like the same bike.
Diba?
Parang special talaga to eh.
It is. Design pa lang.
Ah, this, yeah.
Diba?
So you have the livery here.
The look of the SP talaga. Yeah. Ang pogi niya.
Yeah, I mean, this is the MotoGP colors of Ducati.
Okay.
And it's a little bit special. I like the red seat.
The other Monsters, black yung seats niya. Kasi I heard there's a red version
of the regular Monster. Mm-hmm. But it's easy to change.
Okay.
But this is a little bit taller. Did you notice that?
Yes. This one, I'm flat-footed.
Yeah.
That one, I had to tiptoe a little bit.
Yeah.
Pero abot naman siya. Like, for a 5'2", not bad, diba? Kayang-kaya.
Yeah.
So,
and it's very light.
Kasi, diba, there are bikers who want to try a big bike.
Yeah.
Pero may misconception, ay, Ducati yan, mabilis yan, malakas yan.
Mm-mm.
So, yung iba, like me, personally, medyo natatakot ako before sa Ducati. Kasi nga, that's my
understanding of a Ducati.
Yes.
Yeah.
But then when I tried this one, hindi pa ako matagal nag-ride, but I think if you're a beginner rider, kaya mo siya.
So, there's a price difference between these two bikes.
Okay.
The Monster, because it's the 30-year anniversary of the Monster.
Oh, yes.
There is a sale. And if you buy this bike from Ducati, it is now, they lower the price to 850,000 Philippine pesos, which actually isn't bad anymore.
Yes.
Diba? And then when you buy this bike naman, the SP, it is 1,225,000.
Medyo significant yung difference nila.
That's 375,000 pesos diba? Difference.
Medyo significant. Pero we're talking about what upgrades, yeah. Diba? Kasi the suspension pa lang.
So I mean, the all-in suspension, fully adjustable diba? All-in suspension in the bike, that's what, 100 plus?
So that's one, diba?
Your pipes.
It's upgraded.
That's another close to that, around that price. This one, yeah, this all-in damper, uh-huh. About 50,000 pesos, more or less, depends where you buy it. When I was riding this bike, and I had some experience with the Monster already.
Mm-mm.
And when I was thinking about the upgrades of the SP, I thought to myself, I don't think it's gonna be worth the price difference. Feeling ko lang. Kasi with the price of the SP, the Monster SP, parang close, it's already close to the Street Fighter V2.
Oh,
parang nandun na rin eh. Parang it's not far eh.
And this one is a 900cc bike.
Yeah, right? So it's right below, you know, a little bit underneath 1,000cc. So I thought I wouldn't appreciate the SP until I started riding it. When I started riding it, medyo, I felt a little bit more alive.
Diba?
I felt a little bit more, oh wow, this is a little bit...
Sabi ko nga, yung sound pa lang when you start it, iba na talaga
iba na.
Yung... Iba na. You know you're riding a Ducati bike, diba?
Yeah. I mean, I really enjoyed the SP. And I will say this, for most Ducati owners, wala naman sila pake sa price. So, if you're gonna be if you're gonna buy a Monster, i-SP mo na. Diba?
Get the top of the line na.
But we're not saying, of course, that the regular Monster is... is a major downgrade. It feels like a different bike.
No, kasi yung riding niya, ganun pa rin.
Yeah.
Yes, powerful pa din siya.
So, I want to ask you a question that a lot of people always comment about. Mainit ba yung Monster?
Oh my gosh, it's super hot.
So, the Monster in traffic, not the best bike. It's good kasi it's easy, it's light, you can filter.
Yes.
Okay lang yun eh.
Kaya mo eh.
Kaya eh.
From one lane to another eh. Kayang-kaya eh.
But, yun nga, I mean, it is gonna get warm. I saw your shoes. Medyo...
It is. Merong slight burn dun sa aking leather shoes.
Yeah.
So, ganun siya kainit.
So, if
that's really the downside.
Yeah, if there is one downside, that is the downside of the Monster.
I noticed pala something na, if I get pala the Monster, there's one thing that I would have replaced first.
Yeah.
It's the clutch.
Why?
For me, it's too far. I think you can get naman the one that you can adjust.
Okay, yeah.
And
you can
maybe
that.
Okay for guys na medyo malaki yung hands. But for me, for a lady rider na medyo maliit.
Small hands. Sige nga.
See?
Significant.
Diba? That's the one thing and maybe the only thing.
The only thing that you would change.
That I would change, yeah. Yes.
Okay, that's a good perspective. I've never thought of that. Mm-hmm. I know that is a nice perspective to have about any bike, actually. But in conclusion, I'll say this. The Monster is good.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I agree.
I like the Monster, but this is special.
Yeah.
It feels
special. I like that one better also.
Yeah, I mean, so do I. So do I. But okay na to eh. Happy na ako dito eh. But when you get on this bike, I think it's worth the price difference. I really think so.
Agreed.
And I mean, don't get me wrong, this bike is already good.
Yeah.
But this is special.
Uh-oh.
I mean, the price difference is medyo significant talaga. 375,000 pesos.
It's not. You can actually buy another bike.
You can buy, exactly. That's right? You can buy a second bike. But, I mean, the performance and the look, everything is significantly better as well.
Super, yeah.
So,
agree.
I would do it. I would actually do it. I would choose this over this. All right, so, Steph, it's always great riding with you. And if anybody out there wants to follow Steph Sinco, how do they do it?
Sure, I'm on Facebook, guys. My name is Steph Sinco, so you can just search that name. And I'm also on Instagram, it's Steph.Sinco. TikTok, it's Steph.Sinco. And on YouTube, it's Steph.Sinco.
You really love your name. You love your name.
I love my name.
And if you guys want to learn more about these bikes, you can log on to www.motodeal.com.ph. My name is Jinno Rufino. Until next time, it's Beyond the Ride. Peace!